I now take my position as a member of the general public in the audience.
Regardless, all the judges that are here, all the dignitaries that are here, both mayors and the lunchroom, commissioners, I just thank you for coming. I thank everybody for coming and sharing this moment in time with my family. It's such a great moment, a happiness for me and my family. And I just want to thank God. For this opportunity.
Hallelujah.
When I was first informed about the decision to recommend me to follow in the footsteps of the legendary Judge Larry Potter, I almost fell out. I don't know if I was falling out because I was grateful, I was falling, I was like, really, me? So I called my wife on the way home, I told her, I said, brace yourself. You might want to step outside. And, you know, my wife has always been one of my biggest fans. And so we embarked on this journey because I felt that it was the right thing to do.
My Lord,
I am indeed honored. I'm humbled to be named as the next judge of the Environmental Court. I am so grateful to have been afforded this opportunity and to continue and expand the legacy of Potter House. What I can say about Judge Larry Potter is that he is a man of integrity. He has been my mentor. He's a fine judge, creator of Environmental Court,
right.
A vision to create this court for people on properties that are neglected and abandoned in this city, and for those who refuse to take care of them.
Right.
And as Elwood been said, this party can be very stern and firm.
That's right.
And when it's time to tell citizens you need to do something about it, he doesn't hesitate to do it. Now I have been given the privilege to take this legacy, to nourish it, and to usher in a new era. I do not take this responsibility lightly, and I will do the best of my ability to see this court continue to make a difference in our communities. And now for my family. Those of you who know me, and best understand me and the person who I am, and the little achievement that I have accomplished to this point, I must say because of the love and support of my family and friends. My dad.
Yeah.
78 years,
yeah.
Still holding strong. Been pastoring for over 40 years.
Yeah, I know.
A former postmaster. Yeah. A father who's been there and loved his children to the end.
My Lord.
To the best of his abilities. My dad taught me the value in hard work and determination.
Yeah.
To my mom, may she rest in peace, she taught me that there's always a time to do what is right.
My Lord.
My mom was one of my biggest fans. To my two brothers, Craig and Vincent, I thank you guys for being there for me. We are very close in age, and I must tell you this right now, that they look just like me. It's not always me, you might see. On the front end. I thank you guys for all you've done. to my sister Tammy, a kind and gentle spirit and generous heart. I could have never done it, and you know it. And to my wife for 24 years. You know, when I went to Georgetown, undergrad and law school, because my dad said, you can go anywhere you want to go. He didn't say he's going to help me pay for it. And my wife and I created a little saying. She became my Georgetown cheerleader. And ever since that time, she's been cheering for me. I love you,
man. I know. My man.
And finally, to my three beautiful kids who are actually away in college right now, they're all doing very well. They really kept me on my toes, and I'm just grateful, and I know they would be here if they could. And as I look around the room today, I look at all of the people that I see and I know, several from code enforcement, dignitaries, church members, colleagues, family, Pastor Whalen, Pastor Lemon. I'm just overjoyed. This is a tremendous occasion for me. And I just really appreciate everybody taking the opportunity to come to celebrate this special day with me. And also the judges. If there are judges here, I don't want to start calling the name of Judge Higgins. I want to start calling the names of those who really have been in my corner and supported me. I thank you, judges, so much for that. Today marks the ending of a magnificent career and the beginning of a new era. It will be an era of hard work, determination, integrity, and fairness. These characteristics describe the essence of who I am. You see, my journey started many years ago as a young child growing up in church in the shadows of Pastor Gandrich and a very pious mom. My mom said, do what is right, and my daddy said, all things are possible. And as a child, I used to recite poems. Two of my favorite poems were The Creation by James Weldon Johnson and I'm Determined to Be Somebody by Herbert W. Brewster. In the second poem, which I used to recite all the time, there's this thing that says, my head may be bloody, my skin may be black, but nothing would throw me off the track. I climb the ladder round by round until my feet strike high ground. And when I do, just remember what I say, I'm determined to be somebody someday.
Right.
Those words. Back in my younger days, I used to really do that pretty well. But those words and these words, words are so powerful and they mean so much.
Yeah, man.
And those words meant so much to me that I dared to dream. And I tried to dream big. I wanted to be like Perry Mason. I didn't want to lose a case. You know? So I said I'd go to Georgetown University. I said, I'm going to try and establish my career. So I went to Washington, D.C., Georgetown University. Studied there, I came back to Memphis. I once told people in law school, I said, you guys are coming from all over the country, and if you're not doing well in D.C. or whatever, why don't you just go back to your hometown? And I said that while I was in law school. So I was about 4 years struggling in D.C. A colleague of mine reminded me. He said that, you know what you said? I said, yeah, you're right. And I packed up and I came back home to Memphis. And I'm glad I did. So I soon started gravitating toward the issue of blight and dilapidated structures in our communities. I worked as a city attorney for many years related to environmental concerns, issues that are very important to me. And after working as a city attorney for 15 years, I decided to go down into the trenches. That's right, code enforcement. A job that not many people want to take. And I really wanted to make a difference there, while I was there, and meet some really, really great people, which I did, and established a type of code enforcement that people could be proud of, that were responsive to the neighbors' concerns and issues. And then, Judge Park asked me to be a judge. And I said, wow. I expect, as I move on to be judge, I fully expect to bring the same level of commitment, determination, and dedication to this office as I have been throughout my career. In the new era, we will see continuation of the legacy of a great court. We will continue with the progress that has been made to clean this city and to clean this county, and to make it difficult for outside owners who care nothing about this city to get out.
That's right.
And to care about your neighbors. Also, in the new era, I will have compassion and respect for the elderly and the indigent, and those who are the least among us. Those who have a heart but lack the financial means to take care of their properties and bring them into compliance. We will seek and encourage partnerships, neighborly love, to help those indigent and elderly people who will also continue to be productive citizens the rest of their lives. The new era will also bring fairness. I render judgment in a fair and impartial way, regardless of who you are. The rule of law will govern. The new era will also have respect for all of those who have come before the court. We treat those as if or just like we want to be treated.
Right.
And finally, the new era will see the integrity from the bench. Martin Luther King once said that one of the greatness about this country is the right to stand and in fact protest for what is right. Because you know, there's always a time to do what is right. And as I close today, I feel that it is appropriate at this point in time on the anniversary of the death of a great king, Martin Luther King, who happens to be, of course, one of my heroes growing up. You see, when I was in school and in the public school system, growing up, particularly as a young kid, Martin Luther King was not a holiday. His day was not a holiday, and we would stay out of school. My dad insisted we had perfect attendance, except for one day, until it became a holiday. And Martin Luther King, in one of his quotes, of course, he had a dream. He had a dream that one day his children, along with all our children, would live in a nation, in a county, and in a city, where they would not be judged by the color of their skin, but the content of their character. I have lived my life doing just that, judging people by the content of their character and not the color of their skin. And in my last words, I thank Judge Parker. He did just that. Prayers, your support, and your goodwill as I try to fulfill my obligation and responsibility to the citizens of this county and this city. I will never waver in delivery of justice and do what is just and right and efficient and fair and impartial. Thank you.